Now to the amazing Australian hero who you might never have heard of here, who is being honoured around the world. In 1968, Peter Norman was competing for Australia at the Olympics in Mexico City. He took silver for the US, for us, I should say, in the 200 metres, but it's what happened after the race that really put him on the world stage. As the gold and bronze winners from the US staged a so-called Black Power salute on the podium, Peter said he would stand by them wearing a human rights badge. Now, the move cost him his career and his reputation, but it won him two friends for the rest of his life. And half a century on, Peter's story is being told in a new book by his nephew, Matt Norman, who is with us now. Welcome to the show, Matt.
Thank you so much for having me.
Funnily enough, we're still sort of seeing these protests happening, athletes taking the knee in the United States, which is absolutely infuriating people like Donald Trump. So your uncle standing on the podium in 1968 was a super controversial move and way ahead of his time.
Look, absolutely. And one of the things that people need to understand, it was a silent protest. There was no violence used. And I think what Colin Kaepernick's done as well has made the same sort of statement, where it's nice and silent, no violence being used. And I think that's the most important part when a protest is being made against certain people. And in this case, it was because of the way Black Americans were being treated at home. Mm. You know, they're going to war and shedding their blood, and then they're winning medals at Olympics, but still they weren't being treated.
It was right after Martin Luther King had been assassinated as well.
It was in the same year, Martin Luther King and Robert Kennedy as well, for standing up for black rights at the same time.
Mm. How did your uncle find himself to be in this situation? What made him, because he started actually hearing rumblings and rumours that if these two won, that they were going to make a stand. Yeah. How did he get on board?
Yeah, it was well known that there was going to be a boycott from black nations, and they decided against that at the last minute and said that if you wanted to protest in your own way, that you could. And one of those ways was to wear an Olympic Project for Human Rights badge. They didn't really find out until they got into the winner's room just before going out onto the dais. And at that stage, Peter asked them if he could support them and support their cause by wearing an OPHR badge, which he did. And they said, look, no way, this is an American problem. And he said, well, we've got our own problems in Australia. We just went through the White Australia policy. Yeah. So there was a lot of issues. And he was brought up with the Salvation Army, so he had a lot of insight into issues relating to race back here in the country as well.
Interesting, looking at that iconic photograph, to be, and I'm embarrassed to say, I didn't realise this was an Aussie who won silver.
Yeah.
He's wearing the badge. Symbolism of the black glove?
Yeah, so the symbols of the black glove, strangely enough, Peter was the one that actually told them to wear it on each hand, because John
Carlos...
So
that was his idea.
Yeah, so John Carlos left his gloves back at the Olympic Village, and so Peter said, you're only holding up one hand, so share the gloves. The symbolism was black poverty. That's that's what they claimed. And, you know, for that, once Peter actually put his badge on, it sort of became history, and it's been known for 50 years now. So,
but how did it affect his life? Was he blacklisted as a result of doing this?
Yeah. So when he came home, things didn't look too bad for him with the media, and a lot of people started calling him the N-word and things like that, which was a real shame. But what really happened was within the 4 years later. You know, he was currently number five in the world. He just won a silver medal at the previous Olympics. And he also qualified for the Munich Olympics 15 times during the 100 and 200 metres, and yet he wasn't selected to go to Munich.
So they ostracised him, they just literally blacklisted him for
pretty much
of his life.
Yeah.
How did he cope with that?
With a great sense of humour. He said, you know, if they don't want me to go to the Olympics, I won't go. But on the times he was doing, he would have won gold, so it would have been a real honour to actually get that next stage.
His record still stands.
This is the crazy thing. It's 50 years this week, and he still holds the Commonwealth and Australian record.
Wow.
Which is insane.
Has anybody in these last several years, in a more enlightened era, ever recognised this other than yourself and the documentary you created?
Yeah, so what's happened over the last 16 years is I've literally made this a full-time job. I go and speak to kids at schools and correlate bullying with racism and teaching kids how to see each other as equals. And, you know, I did the Salute documentary 10 years ago today. And that did really well. And in fact, it starts its cinematic run in Italy this week.
Wow. Oh, wow.
10 years later. And there's a new Hollywood feature film coming out. So.
Oh, who's going to play your uncle?
Well, I haven't asked him yet, but I really want Chris Hemsworth to do it.
Very nice.
Yeah, so
look down the camera and ask.
So, Chris Hemsworth, you've got to call me. I've been trying to call your agent.
He's a big fan of the show in Byron Bay. It's a great book. It's called The Peter Norman Story. It is out now. Please thank Matt Norman. What an uncle.
Thank you so much.